about two different patients with same symptoms of significant pain in right hypochondriac region for the past 2 days. I repeat again, it's two different patients. One is a 21-year-old lady and the other one is 10-year-old boy. Giving selected image of ultrasound abdomen focused in the right hypochondriac region to see the gallbladder in long and short axis, being tender on focused compression over gallbladder. Rest of the abdomen appeared unremarkable. First images of the 21-year-old lady with her gallbladder in long and short axis. The second image is of the 10-year-old boy with his gallbladder on long and short axis. If you want more time, please pause the video and review again. I'll give the findings in few seconds. In the lady, there is diffuse circumferential hypoechoic wall thickening of the gallbladder with a calculus in the lumen that you can see. In the 10-year-old boy, there is contracted gallbladder showing few calculi with significant multi-layered wall thickening. Remember, both of them had positive sonographic Murphy sign. Now we know the findings are very classical of calculus cholecystitis, is it? If diagnosed as calculus cholecystitis, I'm sorry, it's going to be wrong because sometimes the pictures will distract our acumen. Now I'm slightly going out of the discussion. Your attention is needed. My radiological lexicon few years back as follows: by the sensitivity of the radiological findings. If the sensitivity is almost 100%, I used to give it as pathognomonic. But if the sensitivity is more than 90%, then it's going to be a consistent or most likely diagnosis. By the same way, might report it as more likely, likely, and suspicious, etc. Radiology and imaging has been given so much of attention now, and it is progressive. That's great. Now the question is, clinical acumen is important or not in our setting? I will say sometimes radiological lexicons are almost useless without any clinical history. It is better to be a prompt clinical radiologist rather than a good imaging specialist. Now coming back to our scenario, the images of both the patients are classical of calculus cholecystitis, but the additional clinical history is pertinent to confirm or rule out the radiological diagnosis. In our case, that lady has been having intermittent fever for the past 4 days. After counseling more, she told that the calculus had been there while undergoing antenatal ultrasound 1 year back. The same way, in that boy, he has been having recurrent emesis, means recurrent vomiting, for the past 3 days. And the right hypochondriac pain is more now. That's why the patient has come for ultrasound. We know at this time, we have COVID virus, which is a pandemic now. In that same way, dengue virus was epidemic in Tamil Nadu at that time. So by the clinical history, I reported both of them suspicious for dengue fever. I was right in that lady who came zero positive for dengue, but the boy came zero negative for dengue. But still the boy didn't go for surgery as the liver function tests were altered and he came positive for hepatitis A. Yes, the sonographic findings are also consistent with acute viral hepatitis and not calculus cholecystitis. Many years back, I used to think the positive sonographic Murphy sign with the presence of multiple calculi in gallbladder and significant GB wall thickening are almost pathognomonic of acute or subacute calculus cholecystitis. Now, after that incidences and few more, I remove the pathognomonic portion from my radiological lexicon. Now, please again go through the final radiological lexicon. Please remember, this can be varied by different countries or different states or even in districts, or it might be individualized personally. That's the end of the session. Thank you very much for your attention. Please give your views in the comment section. Please definitely share this with your colleagues and juniors. Take care. Thank you again.